A few days ago, I woke up to what felt like 1,000 messages from friends and viewers alike, letting me know that there was a new Altergeist support. Altergeist are one of my favorite strategies, I'm sure a lot of you already know that, so to hear that they were getting more support was really exciting. Not to mention how happy I was when I found out that there were 4 new cards, not just one. The OCG will get these cards in just a few weeks, but we won't see them in the TCG until late July. The release date for this set, coincidentally, is on my birthday, so I guess this was Konami's happy birthday gift to me. The first new card is Altergeist Adminia, a Link 4 Dark Spellcaster effect monster that takes 2 plus Altergeist monsters to bring out. This card says, if this card is Link summoned, you can set 1 Altergeist trap directly from your deck. Once, while face up on the field during the main phase quick effect, you can send 1 card you control to the graveyard, then target 1 effect monster your opponent controls, take control of it, and if you do, it is treated as an Altergeist monster. In more than one way, Adminia is what I expected out of Altergeist Memory Gant when that card originally released. While it's nice having that card to OTK the opponent, I really felt like Altergeist were looking for a new boss monster, not a new OTK tool. And Altergeist Adminia does look to be a good boss monster for Altergeist to play alongside Hextia. On Link Summon, you get to immediately set a trap card. Usually, you're probably thinking of Protocol or Manifestation, but you might branch out and play Haunted Rock, I suppose. I've seen some people do combos with that already. And then on top of that, it has this Comic Hand effect as well that can take an opponent's monster and turn it into an Altergeist monster, which then allows it to be used for Protocol and Hextia's costs. That is a big effect. I really do like this card quite a bit. With Altergeist, it can be difficult to break bigger boards. You know, you have your Meloseek to get rid of one card, and you might have a Silk Bounce, but outside of that, it can be kind of tough. With Adminia, though, you can not only steal a monster, but then hopefully attack over 2 monsters, perhaps. One with your big Adminia with a 3000 attack, and one with a monster you stole. And that's obviously ignoring if you had other Altergeist cards as well. But Adminia looks even better when you look at the new main deck monster card, Altergeist Maulwisp. Maulwisp is a level 3 light spellcaster tuner monster, we'll talk about that more in a moment here, and it says, if this card is added to your hand except by drawing it, you can special summon it. If this card is normal or special summoned, you can target 1 Altergeist monster in your graveyard, except Altergeist Maulwisp, special summon it in defense position, but it cannot activate its effects this turn. This should be pretty easy to special summon, all you have to do is add it to your hand with a card effect, so maybe Meloseek, maybe Personal Spoofing, and then on normal or special summon, you get that value of reviving an Altergeist monster. With this card in the mix, you can do a combo that goes through Hextia and the Link 4 monster to get you to an entire setup off of just Meloseek Pookery, and that's pretty scary off of 2 cards. There's a couple different variations that you can do with this combo, but this basic one that I'm showing you guys here gets you to the Link 4, which can steal a monster, Protocol, which can negate a monster effect by then sending that stolen monster to the graveyard, and a Multifaker in hand, which can then go into Silk for a bounce. One of the ways that they balanced Altergeist on release was that they weren't really able to do their combo on turn 1. But with these new cards, I really feel like Altergeist players have the opportunity to combo on turn 1 and consistently set up a pretty strong board. This card is also just a good piece of recovery. It's a 1 card Hextia if you have an Altergeist in grave already, and it's a great top deck in grind games, which Altergeist definitely get into a lot. Now in regards to this being a tuner, I don't think this makes the Altergeist synchro playable, but I do think it matters quite a bit for other combos. Throughout that entire combo we looked at earlier, we were never Altergeist locked by Multifaker, so you don't have to only summon the Altergeist synchro with this card. In that combo, there's a good example where you have on the board Hextia, the level 3 tuner, and Meloseek. At that point, if you already have access to Faker, you could just go into Herald of the Arclight using Meloseek and the new tuner monster. Arcanite Magician also seems like a pretty good option, and I'm sure there's some pretty crazy things that you can do with Arcanite and Selene. Next up, we have Altergeist, word I can't pronounce. This is a level 1 fire spellcaster monster that says this card can attack directly. When this card inflicts battle damage to your opponent, you can draw 1 card, and if this card is sent from the field to the graveyard, you can send 1 Altergeist card from your hand, deck, or face of field to the graveyard. So this is kind of an interesting take on an alternate version of Meloseek. It has the same stat line, but it's fire instead of water, and instead of sending a card to the graveyard, it draws a card. Now what about that final effect? What cards can we send to the graveyard here? Obviously, you can send whatever monster you want to, and then you can revive it with cards like Manifestation or Marionetter, but I think you are meant to send cards that actually have graveyard effects, so let's go through those and see what they do. Manifestation obviously has a good graveyard effect, but maybe not one worth building a deck around. Altergeist Failover is kind of like Manifestation, but for monster cards. Unfortunately, the on-field effect is pretty lackluster. Altergeist Camouflage has a similar situation where the graveyard effect is okay, it has a protection effect, but the on-field effect is so bad that you wouldn't really want to play it in a deck. And finally, we're going to look at a new new card in just a moment here that has a graveyard effect as well. When we look at the cards that might be targets for this, we see a lot of things that don't really have good on-field effects and only have okay graveyard effects. Not to mention that the damage effect is significantly worse than Meluseek's, because oftentimes in Altergeist you want to play Pot of Prosperity, Pot of Extravagance, these types of cards that restrict you from drawing, which means they're going to conflict with this new monster card, and you're not going to cut Extravagance to play this. With Meluseek, the reason it's so good is because it has two very threatening effects. When it's on the field, it's really annoying because it threatens to send a card to the grave, but you don't really want to get rid of it because then it might trigger the effect to search a multi-faker. With this card though, it's like, I don't really know. Do you even care if it gets destroyed if you're an opponent? Finally, we have Altergeist Revitalization. This is a normal trap card that says, target one Altergeist Link monster in your graveyard, special summon it. You can banish this card from your graveyard immediately after this effect resolves, normal summon one Altergeist monster. Let's talk about the on-field effect first. This revives an Altergeist Link monster in your graveyard, and to be completely honest, most of the time that you're using Manifestation, it's doing that as well. But you do use Manifestation to summon Multifaker and Meluseek and Silk and sometimes Concrete and Marionetter, so that is definitely a downside of this card over Manifestation, but that graveyard effect is pretty darn appealing. I would kill for an extra normal summon in Altergeist sometimes, because you just get in those spots where you cannot do anything against your opponent's board, and having an extra normal summon could be pretty cool. I've even considered playing double summon in Altergeist in the past before Pookery just to make Hexty on turn one. But where this card gets a little bit worse is when you realize that Manifestation's revival effect is not a once per turn. So realistically, if you felt like you didn't have enough revival in your deck, you could have just played more copies of Manifestation. And that really brings us back to the mindset of the other Altergeist trap cards that had okay graveyard effects, but kind of lackluster on field effects. You don't really want to play those cards in your deck, or at least not too many of them, unless you have a big payoff. And I don't think that right now that payoff is there. But where does this leave Altergeist? Because we're a few years past the Altergeist prime at this point. You know, they're not even considered a rogue deck, and they're really struggling compared to other trap decks out there. So they did need more support if Konami wanted them to be viable. And I do appreciate that Konami gave them more support, but these cards aren't quite enough. We do have two really good new cards. The Link 4 and the Tuner are fantastic cards that I can't wait to try out. But the other two at this point are kind of misses in my mind. It'd be cool if they released more cards to play with this, like putting trap cards in the grave to trigger their effects. You know, maybe give Altergeist like a card that has a really good on-field effect, but also in the graveyard can be banished to add an Altergeist monster. That'd be kind of interesting. Give them a Foolish Burial Goods target. Why not, right? And then also, even though I know every deck can probably say this, I do think Altergeist really could use a Link 1 monster. It's fun using Link Kribo and All Mirage and Relinquished Anima and stuff like that, but I do think that Altergeist would be better with a solid Link 1 monster, and I hope Konami gives them that sometime in the future. Anyway, that is all for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you to Konami for the great birthday present of new Altergeist support. I can't wait for it in a few months. It's going to be a lot of fun. I'll see you guys later. Thanks so much for watching. Goodbye.